this was an interesting case where Mrs. Sunitha Penumacha came to us for termination of pregnancy. That's because she had lost hope. She had already lost 2 to 3 babies and she had lots of bad obstetric history. She had blood transfusions. She had gone, she was seeing regular doctors outside, and she was in a very high risk center where her hemoglobin had dropped to 2 grams. So she was really afraid of going through this pregnancy. We convinced her, and we held her hand. We said, let's look at your history. Let's see why you're losing so many babies. So we started investigating her. We said, if we don't find an answer to your solution, yes, you can go ahead and terminate. And we investigated her. We found her that she's suffering from APLA syndrome or antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, which is very, very common, which is the reason for all these pregnancy losses which she had gone through. We found her to be having systemic lupus erythematosus also, which went really undiagnosed till then. We took a rheumatologist opinion. We continued with the pregnancy with all sorts of medications, which are supportive medications for her. Then when we went through the history and when we got the diagnosis, we gave her the courage. We started on medications. We admitted her. Everything went smooth. So at 28 weeks of pregnancy, we admitted her into the hospital because that's when she was losing her babies prior. So we have a team of doctors here who work together. So the birthright team, that's the obstetricians, and the NICU team, Dr. Rajat's team, we all sat together to decide when is the right time to deliver this patient. So we kept her in-house, we kept her here from 28 weeks onwards, but 32, when we thought that yes, the baby is mature enough to come out now and it will require minimal support in the NICU, and the baby was 1.5 to 1.6 kgs by ultrasound, then we delivered her by an elective cesarean section. The baby spent about 15 days in the NICU and was handed over to the parents after that. The most gratifying case of my career, probably, because this was really unwarranted. Actually, she could have got diagnosed the first time itself when she was losing a baby without any reason. The first time she was having an abruption, nobody thought about investigating her, unfortunately. And she went through all this multiple times. 3 times she went through the same thing. She was with 2 grams of hemoglobin, admitted in a very high risk center in an ICU. The amount of blood transfusions she has lost, the amount, the track of blood transfusion she got in ICU to stop that bleeding.
I am Venkat Subbaraju of Penumacha. I along with my wife visited Dr. Kavita Kovi Madam in December 2017. During our maternity time, before the pregnancy, we stayed for 1 month, and after the pregnancy, we stayed in the NICU with the baby for 1 month. During all this course of time, the support staff, nursing staff, we actually felt that they have taken a very, very extraordinary help and support, and. The support staff sinking the support staff by Kavita Kovi Madam for the right people according to the issue of the patient. It was actually, we felt that it is impossible is possible in her practice.
త్రీ అబార్షన్స్ అయినాయి. తర్వాత ఇక్కడికి వచ్చిన తర్వాత మంచి ట్రీట్మెంట్ బాగా జరిగింది. డాక్టర్ ఫస్ట్ నుంచి డెలివరీ అయ్యే వరకు బాగా ట్రీట్మెంట్, సిస్టర్స్ కానీ డాక్టర్ కానీ బాగా కేర్ తీసుకున్నారు. నాకు బాగానే ట్రీట్మెంట్ జరిగింది. మెడిసిన్స్ అవి కూడా కరెక్ట్ టైంకి ఆమె బాగా చూశారు. నన్ను కవిత డాక్టర్ గారు కేర్ బాగా తీసుకున్నారు. అది నాకు 8 మంత్స్ 15 డేస్కి డెలివరీ అయింది. అప్పుడు కూడా డాక్టర్స్ బాగా కేర్ తీసుకోవటం వల్ల నాకు మంచిగా అబ్బాయి పుట్టాడు. బాబు పుట్టినందువల్ల నాకు ఎంతో సంతోషంగా ఉంది.